Did he give you any advice or tell you anything specifically after the game?
No, didn't have enough time. All right.
That's a wrap. Pop was really pleased about the effort tonight. Said it was so different from the Indiana and New York games. Was that the feeling in the locker room, that, you know, kind of a moral victory of sorts?
Yeah, it's doesn't happen often, you know, games where you know you did good still, and you learn, and you're still proud of yourself, you know, of the team. But tonight is a good learning experience, and you know, more and more we're one of the teams that learns the most about ourselves in the league. I'm sure of it every night. So it's, you know, our progression through the year is going to be very, very impressive.
So is that Rudy's jersey you've got there?
Which, sorry?
Is that Rudy's jersey you've
yes.
got there?
Yes.
Okay, he gave that to you?
Yeah.
And you gave him yours?
Yes.
Without going into too much detail, the routine after the game, what is that something you've always done your whole career, and what are the specifics of that? And do you think a lot about the night as you're doing this? Or what is the routine?
So before last year, I never lifted before games because we never needed to. But last year in France, in order to prepare for the NBA, I lifted after every game because we need to take the off days to actually recover, since we play every 2 days or every 1 day sometimes. We lift after every game, and then recover, you know, all different type of stuff, that's it. And then media.
Is there mental stuff going on back there when you're back there for an hour, or are you replaying the game or anything like that?
No, you know, we're still in the heat of it, so not really, but not much long after, yes.
What did you think about your team's defensive performance tonight, maybe compared to the last couple games?
We've had ups and downs, but I think we're fixing some stuff every time, you know, and we can get much better. But we're as the youngest team of the league, I think we're already doing a good job in the intentions. But now we gotta be good as a fact.
And that 3-2 zone you guys use with you at the top a little bit, do you like that look, and do you like what you get to do in that situation?
Of course, yes, of course. Yeah. And I think it's something interesting, and just like in offense, we need to vary our weapons.
Did the blocks against Rudy, for everything that he's meant to you, did those mean a little bit more to be able to get one or get a few on him?
Did it mean more? On the moment, no, but maybe when I look back on it, yes.
Devin mentioned the third quarter as sort of a turning point in letting the game get away a little bit before you came back. Mm-hmm. What happened during that third quarter that affected you all?
I think it's the sometimes just we don't really know what to do. Maybe we try to look at the coach too much, but and we need to have, you know, our own responsibility on the court, you know, to know what we're doing, to know who we're guarding, and to not have any time where we're disconnected. So it's just, you know, we're learning.
You mentioned that the zone was a little bit of a problem.
Is yes.
That, what kind of effect does that have on an offense schematically?
So it stops us from running the play the normal way, but just in our head, because factually we can still run it. So we don't encounter it very often, but now I'm sure we're going to work on it.
Devin had matched a career high tonight with 29. You've seen what he can do when he's healthy. What's he going to mean?
That was a career high for him?
He matched a career high.
Okay, cool.
What's he going to mean for you and the franchise, you know, playing with him going forward, having him by your side?
Yes, Devin has been very impressive, you know, ever since I came in San Antonio, you know, not just as a player, but also as a leader, you know, of the court too. I'm very, very hopeful, and I have zero worries for him, you know, it's, and for the future, for his future in this franchise, you know, it's good to have guys like this.
He also guaranteed you're going to win on Sunday.
Really?
Yeah.
I trust him.
Take a couple in French, Maxime.
Ouais, j'ai parlé avec lui dans le vestiaire, en fait, à l'instant, de toi. La relation que vous avez ensemble, il m'a dit, j'adore à quel point je peux parler de choses profondes avec lui, notamment. Il m'a parlé du dîner que vous avez eu hier aussi. Il m'a dit des sujets comme la philosophie, par exemple, qu'on peut avoir ensemble à son jeune âge. Est-ce que c'est, justement, à quel point c'est un sujet qui t'intéresse? Est-ce qu'il y a des auteurs, des courants de pensée ou, qui t'intéressent en particulier?
Alors, c'est vrai que c'est, enfin, Rudy, c'est une personne, bien sûr, à qui, pour moi, c'est facile, de s'ouvrir et de parler de sujets profonds. Mais disons que je pense que, enfin, j'aime bien réfléchir et faire les choses avec, comment dire, avec un sens. Donc, mais je suis loin d'être un expert en philosophie, même s'il y a des courants que j'aime bien, bien sûr.
Et qu'est-ce que tu retires du jeu de Rudy? Tu as dû sans doute pouvoir beaucoup jouer en NBA. Est-ce que tu as appris des choses de lui? Est-ce que tu as appris des choses de son jeu? Qu'est-ce qui t'a inspiré chez lui?
Ce qui est à prendre absolument dans le jeu de Rudy, pour moi, c'est sa présence défensivement. Il est grand et très grand, mais il paraît même plus grand, tellement il utilise bien son envergure et sa taille, qu'il paraît même plus grand que des joueurs qui sont plus grands que lui, mais moins mobiles et moins aérien, moins réactif sur les contres, donc c'est vraiment cette intimidation qui est importante.
Sur le maillot, il le tient en tout cas dans le vestiaire, il l'a regardé pendant très longtemps et il m'a dit celui-là, je vais l'encadrer chez moi et je vais montrer aussi qu'il est dessus et tout. Est-ce que tu vas faire pareil ou...
Ah bien sûr, c'est, ça a de la valeur.
Thanks, Vex.
Merci.